In just 3 hours, Boris Johnson will step down as UK Prime Minister. And love him or loathe him, Britain's never seen a leader quite like him.
When the herd moves, it moves. And my friends, in politics, no one is remotely indispensable.
Yes, that's me. You're probably wondering how I ended up in this situation.
The downfall of Boris Johnson was much like his prime ministership, as unlikely as it was inevitable.
I can tell you the price of a bottle of champagne. How about that? Is that the kind of thing you want me to say?
By the time he was elected PM in 2019, Boris was already a notorious figure with global recognition, a scandal-plagued journalist whose TV appearances...
Permission to obfuscate.
...helped propel him to the office of London Mayor, where he chaotically distracted from his many controversies with ridiculous stunts. These moments only seemed to make Boris more popular, and in 2015 he arrived in Parliament just in time to take advantage of the upcoming Brexit referendum.
Take the chance now!
Positioning himself as the face of the Leave campaign.
Do you think that the British taxpayer should be supporting Spanish bullfighting?
No!
If it hadn't been for Boris Johnson, Remain could have won the referendum in 2016.
The UK has voted to leave the European Union.
Brexit felled two prime ministers, paving the way for Boris, despite his protestations at his own chances.
It's more likely that, as I say, I will be decapitated by a flying frisbee.
But with no frisbees on the horizon, Boris sailed into number 10, promising to...
get Brexit done.
And get it done he did, achieving what his predecessor could not. And the UK formally left the EU in January 2020.
We did it! We pulled it off, didn't we?
But with Brexit pulled off and the economic fallout becoming apparent, Boris was able to soften the blow by helping Britain become one of the world's foremost manufacturers of political scandal.
A growing political crisis.
Allegations about Boris Johnson and the refurbishment of his flat.
A reportedly £200,000 refurbishment.
Now admitting that he attended a garden party at 10 Downing Street.
Laughing and joking about how to explain the gathering.
The police believe Boris Johnson broke the law.
Apologised to Queen Elizabeth for hosting parties last year.
And the fact that he was booed at the Jubilee.
And yet, none of those were, on their own, able to bring down a man who thrived on chaos.
You know, if I had my time again, I would recognise that he wasn't going to learn.
Oh, that wasn't a moment of self-reflection. That was Boris talking about Chris Pincher, the deputy whip accused of sexually assaulting multiple people. Reports that Boris had ignored and even joked about the scandal were the final straw.
Two unexpected high-profile cabinet resignations.
Nine individuals resigned from his government today.
Now 27 resignations.
Mm-hmm. Even for Boris, it was clear this was it, and he announced he was stepping down, which is where we came in.
I want you to know how sad I am to be giving up the best job in the world. But them's the breaks.
Boris's friends claim he may mount a comeback. But for now, at least, after 3 years at the top, the man himself has just one thing to say.
Hasta la vista, baby. Thank you.
Well, the world certainly lost a political character. There's no doubt about that. But to his credit, his commitment to Ukraine has been unwavering. He's been there, I think, three times. To his discredit, the small things got him. Renovating number 10, having parties during COVID was never going to wash.
Weren't that small, though. That's the problem. Like, of all the stuff that he did, the anger of the British people towards that was palpable. And so it took on a symbolic size that was just gigantic. But the interesting thing is it seems partisan. So there's polling showing that 50% of Tory voters think he shouldn't have resigned and he's more popular than anyone who's going to succeed him.
And he's convinced himself he can come back.
Is he going to come back?
He's convinced himself he can.
Should we do a... That's not what I asked, though. Is he going to come back?
Yes.
Great. Well, we've got something to hold him to.
It'll be a decent farewell party he's going to throw for himself, I imagine.
At Downing Street as well.
Yeah,
have to announce a lockdown first.
Yeah.